Rip Rap Glue Prusa i3 is a very good, inexpensive DIY 3D printer. However, I have some issue with printing the first few layers. As you can see on the printer bed, the loop I was trying to print in, only the left side was printed and the right side was not printed. This shows my printer has some bad leveling issue. Today, I'm going to show you how to add auto bed leveling capability to this printer. First, let's take off the printer cooling fan by these two screws. After you taking them off, you will see a lot of washers, a heat sink, and two cylindrical aluminum spacers. We are going to replace these two aluminum spacers with my own printed plastic brackets. The brackets will be used to hold the auto bed leveling sensor. So put the brackets onto the heatsink and put them back into the screw and then tighten them back onto the printer head. And the model for the plastic brackets is attached in the description section of this video. You can download it and print yourself. Let's put the washers back onto the assembly and then put the whole assembly back onto the printer head. Now, let's tighten the screws. As you can see, the two aluminum spacers are left out and replaced by the plastic bracket. Next step is to assemble the approach sensor. The sensor part number is LJ18A3-8-Z/BX. It has a 8mm sensing distance and works with 6 to 36 volts. It has an orange tip, do not buy the blue tip version. This sensor is NPN NO type or normally open type sensor. The sensor has three wires. The brown wire connects to 6 to 36 volts positive power source, and the blue wire connects to the negative power source. The black wire connects to the signal. Even though it's specified to be 6 volts minimum, but it also works with 5 volts, which is our printer provides. Let's connect the three wires to the controller. In order to do that, I first extend the three wires to a female jumper wire cable. I do not have a blue cable, so I replaced it with a white one. Locate the two white ribbon cables that's connecting to the LCD screen on one end of the controller board, and the pins that we are going to connect to are located at the corner next to the two white cables. There are three extra pins immediately next to the Z stop wires. We are going to connect the brown wire towards the middle of the board, the white or the blue wire in the middle, and the black wire towards the outside of the board. You can see the three X, Y, and Z wires for the end stop, and our sensor wires are connected to the pins right next to the Z stop. Next, let the printer go home in Z direction, and then adjust the sensor position until you see the top of the sensor light up in red. The sensor can sense the copper heating elements beneath the glass top because it has an 8 mm sensing distance. It can sense through the glass and reach the copper below it. Let's secure the sensor to the bracket. Now, we will measure the distance between the extruder to the middle of the sensor head. Let's put a marker underneath the extruder and then use your software to control the movement and move the middle of the sensor head to the marker and record the distance you moved in X and Y direction. In this case, the X direction moved 45 millimeters and the Y moved 15 millimeters. We're going to use those numbers later. Next, disconnect the sensor wires and the Z-stop wires. Basically, we're going to switch out the Z-stop wires and then switch in the sensor wires to the same place where the Z-stop was connected to. So the Z-stop wires are replaced by the new sensor wires. Again, the brown wire connect to the pin towards the inside of the board. The white or the blue wire connect to the middle pin, and the black wire connects to the pin to the outside of the board. When it's done, it looks like this. You can see the X and Y end stop wires and our sensor wires, the Z stop wires, are not used anymore. We are done with the hardware modification, and then let's move on to software configuration. First, go to computer and launch Arduino software. Open the .ino file, and you will see a tab showing the configuration.h file. Scroll down until you find the Zmin probe, use Zmin end stop pin, and uncomment that line by deleting the two slashes at the beginning of the line. And also uncomment the fixed mount probe because our probe is fixed position, it cannot move. Some other probes can move, but ours is fixed. And then adjust the probe positions by typing in the two numbers that we measured earlier. It is 45 and 15, pay attention to the negative or positive. Enable the double touch so that the sensors are more accurate at measuring distances. Optionally, you can enable the Zmin probe reliability test command so that you can test the sensor reliability using M48 code. And I'm going to turn on the auto bed leveling using bilinear methods. And the points that I'm going to use to measure my auto leveling bed change it from 3 points to 4 points or 4x4 matrix. And also those parameters specify what location our sensors can reach. You have to adjust it, otherwise it will go outside of your printer bed. So if you use my bracket attached and you will type in those numbers, 15, 145, 30, and 170. They will work with the bracket and the sensor. And I also want to turn on the extrapolate beyond the grid points. And turn on the ABL bilinear subdivision to make the auto bed leveling more accurate. Also, I enabled the LCD bed leveling so that you can control it through the LCD dial. This is very important. You have to enable the Z safe home, otherwise it can crash your printer bed because the Z sensor wires were disconnected. In addition, optional, I turn on the EEPROM settings so that I can save all the bed adjustment settings to the EEPROM. This one is optional for the ABS preheat. Right now it's 225 Fahrenheit. It is too low. Change it to 250. And that's it. Let's upload the configuration to the controller board. Next, let's measure the distance between the sensor and the printer bed. It is also the Z value of the sensor. Let's first preheat the printer bed and the head to your normal printing temperature and let the head go home. Then slide a piece of paper underneath the printer head and check if the paper is tight. If it's too tight, move the printer head up. If it's too loose, move the printer head down until the paper is snug but not too tight. You should be able to move the paper back and forth but not very freely. At this time, your Z value is set and let's record the value show up on the screen. In my case, it's 1.09 millimeters. Let's open the Arduino software and open the configuration.h file. Scroll down and locate the Z probe offset from extruder. Right now it's zero. Let's type in -1.09. Save and upload the sketch to the printer. Let's find out how good is our sensor. In Reptile host, type in M48 and click send, and the printer will start to measure the sensor accuracy. When it's done, you will get a report. In my case, between all the repeated measurements, the difference is only 0.005 millimeters. That's fantastic. Now, let's type in M501 command to restore printer settings from the EEPROM. Next, let's type in G29 to start auto bed leveling. The printer will start to measure all the points that's defined in the configuration.h file. At the end of it, a report of all the measurements will be provided. As you can see from the data points, my bed is not very flat. Now, type in M500 command to save all the measurement settings into your EEPROM so that you can reuse it later. That's all. Have fun with your printer.